Here we are, next day. I got the wife's 5'9" here and the no longer the wife's 5'9" over here, which by the way, you can enter to win this truck at lnpgear.com. Check the description always for any special promos we might be running. This truck giveaway does end on April 16th, so it is rapidly ending and you don't have a whole lot of time left to enter to win it. So hit the link in the description, lnpgear.com. Place an order, get entered to win this thing before it is gone. We're gonna be firing up her third gen here this morning because we've got a new little install for this truck. So the wife has horses, of course, and she's planning on pursuing more stuff with the horse stuff. And she has purchased a very, very large item that requires some modifications to be made to her truck. We're gonna get this thing fired up here and pull it into the garage. For those of you that have not caught on yet, we're talking about a gooseneck hitch setup for the wife's third gen because she has purchased something. If you're putting the pieces of the puzzle together, you probably already get it all figured out, but she's purchased something that is absolutely massive and she is going to need a gooseneck hitch to hook this thing up to her truck and to be able to use it. And I do have some other parts that are also gonna help with the fact that this is a short bed truck with the item that she has purchased. It's already been purchased, we just have to go pick it up. We do need to get this all installed. And although I'm not usually that big anymore on tutorial videos, I'm gonna at least give you my ins and outs, my honest opinion, honest review on this hitch for this truck. It's a Curt, and from what I read, it was like highly recommended by a lot of people that have bought it, and the reviews are pretty stinking good. The only reviews that I did not like to see, and there was like two or three of them, and I was like, I hope this doesn't happen to me. They said that they got the box, and since it's so heavy, it's so big, stuff tore open, parts were missing, bolts were missing, stuff like that from shipping. And I'm like, oh, well, hopefully that doesn't happen to me, because there was a lot of good reviews, but there was just a couple that said that. So I don't really know if we're gonna have, you know, parts missing, bolts missing. If that's the case, it sucks. But, you know, I have a hardware store 5 minutes away that carries literally everything. It looks like most of it should be there. I mean, that's a pretty full bag of hardware. It's hard to ship something that heavy with all those little pieces to make sure that they don't get lost. But Curt should definitely consider rethinking the packaging strategy because it is not fun when people get stuff and they're missing a bunch of parts. For their smaller thing here, I mean, this is good packing because they put all the hardware inside of a box that's taped up that was inside of another box, you know. So, you know, it'd have to get out of the box and out of a bag for you to lose any hardware. The big box was just a big old box with a bag of bolts thrown in the bottom with paper thin plastic that of course is easy to tear. But let's get into this. Hopefully we're not missing anything. And hopefully somehow, by the grace of God, all of the bolts that were loosely in the box, we somehow didn't lose any and they're all familiar. But we will find out. Let's get into the project. No help from anyone else. The bullets fly with the shells. I'm gonna start to rebel and build an army to help the strongest you've ever felt. I feel a change in the wind. The world is shifting again. It's time to go all in. I'm bringing all of my friends, and now we're playing to win. We ride or die to the end. Look at myself in the mirror. I just wanna see clearer. Feel a little angst, I'm sick of my life. I just wanna make a change. The world is calling my name. I'm a little afraid, but I need to be brave. Cause when my head is filled with doubt, I just wanna be fearless. We'll be right back. everybody, we are about 2 hours into this process and it's really not been a hard process at all. It's been pretty simple. You just read through the directions. It's pretty self-explanatory. Just like I feared, hardware must have fallen out of the box because we're missing like 4 or 5 different bolts and like 3 nuts and a couple of hex style square hole washers. And so we have to run to the store and buy that stuff. Now, luckily, the stuff that we are missing, it's all the same size hex flange nuts in the same size 1.5 inch long by 1/2 inch carriage bolts. So all I'm gonna have to do is take one of each and then the square hole washers and stuff like that. I know exactly what to grab for that stuff. But I'm just gonna take it, match it up with the grade that those are and pick it up, bring it back. We should be good to go, but everything's pretty much done. I mean, of course, this is one of those that we were missing, of course. There's supposed to be a bolt right there and a bolt through there. And then there's 2 more that are supposed to be up under the bed right there and one on the far end there, which those are, I actually have those, but since I'm missing the nuts, I can't run them through. But I'm gonna take a couple of pieces of that hardware with me so I can match it up. But in terms of everything else, I mean, like removing the bump stop and putting the brackets in, lining everything up. It's all pretty much good to go. And I was gonna have to go to the hardware store anyways to buy a hole saw because I need a 4 5/8 inch hole saw to cut the hole in the bed for the ball, which again should also be pretty self-explanatory because I've already got the main bracket and everything up underneath the bed. And so all I have to do is drill 1 pilot hole in the dead center of that. And then after that, go from the top side using that pilot hole and run the hole saw down through just to cut that small hole in the bed, which should be pretty stinking easy. But other than that, we're gonna hop in the car, run on over to the store. Hopefully we can find what we need, get on back over here, and this thing should look pretty good. And what other truck would we take than the old Rosine 24V, since we're not gonna have her a whole lot longer. That truck could be yours.
This is what they call paradise.
Right. That's a little point.
Yeah, that's a point.
Carriage bolt. Here's some carriage bolts. Gotta make sure they're the right stinking grade, though.
Something about all these bolts just perfectly put together just gets you excited.
It's pretty exciting stuff, honestly.
I mean, look at that. It's not really light.
You like in a drawer? Yeah, fancy around here. It kind of like followed us around the whole time.
I know. But we got the goods, right?
Oh. Here's what we're gonna do with this whole bag of bolts here.
Oh, wait. How beautiful that is.
Yeah, so.
It's like gold.
So they didn't actually have what I needed. And you're probably thinking, is this a gooseneck to haul a lot of weight? Like, you don't screw this up, bro. But I did get grade 8 bolts, same length, same thread pitch, same diameter, all that stuff, with locking nuts. And I'm gonna use some of these washers, you know. So it's gonna be great. It's gonna be awesome. This isn't gonna like hurt anything. They just didn't have any carriage bolts. That's the only thing. They didn't have any carriage bolts. Let's get to finishing this up.
Oh, my enemy. It's in my mind how I redefine everything. I know who I am, what I want, a clear identity. I can feel the quest, it's pulling me in. I don't wanna rest, I need to begin. I listen to my chest, I feel it in the wind. I know that I'm obsessed, that's how I'm gonna win. Yeah, I trained for this. Yeah, I prayed for this. I didn't change for this. I was made for this. I can feel the quest, it's pulling me in. I don't want no rest, I need to begin. I listen to my chest, I feel it in the wind. I know that I'm obsessed, that's how I'm gonna win. Yeah, I trained.
4.5 hour projects.
Maybe five.
For those projects that like, you go thinking like, this ain't gonna be so bad to like, you literally hate it by the time you're done with it. So this is an offset ball. Here's the one that it came with, 2 5/16. But since this is a short bed truck, item that Reagan is picking up is, well, it's pretty big. And even the front end of it's more squared than anything else. So we're gonna use this offset ball to give us just an extra 4 inches of clearance away from the cab, which will help a little bit. And then we may even have to modify slightly with an adapter that they make from Kurt, another attachment that goes into the gooseneck hitch and on the said item, which I'm assuming you guys understand at this point is a trailer we haven't got on, and it offsets another 10 inches, which is basically to try to give you a little bit more distance away from the cab so that you have good backing around and sharp turn radius, like you don't lose all that. So with a short bed truck, it's a little bit trickier using, let's say, a square front trailer, because you can't take as sharp turns and you can't take as sharp of angles backing into places, which kind of is the reason why a lot of people like goosenecks, because they can do a little sharper angle stuff that you can't normally do with a bumper pull style trailer. This is supposed to help compensate that a little bit. So instead of losing that ability, you can kind of regain that, and it creates a little bit more distance between the trailer and the cab. So pull the pin tie, which is down by you. You can pull the big red lever, pull it all the way, drop it, let it go. And that's it. And that is the offset ball for her setup. And we are gonna keep this one. Of course, we're not just gonna get rid of it. I mean, this sucker's heavy. For the time being, that's the way we're gonna roll it. So if you guys wanna come check this out, it is actually a no frame drilling kit from Kurt. I don't remember the exact model. I can try to remember to drop the links in the description below, the affiliate links down there for you guys to tap on. But it was highly rated and it was their double lock system. Whatever that means, other than the fact that there's two pins, I'm guessing is part of what that means. But it's pretty slick. Pull it out, you can offset it so you can go out, pull your ball, drop your new one in or flip it, whatever you're gonna do, and then just twist it and let go. Slams in, you got two solid pins going all the way through the ball there. It's all bolts on with U-bolts that sandwich the whole kit to the frame, which is pretty, I mean, it's pretty nice. I thought a gooseneck, you know, I know there are some like this, but I thought it would require, no matter what, to be drilling the frame and stuff like that. And in this case, it just wasn't. I mean, you can see it, other than having to bend this little tab here, other than having to bend that, which could have been nicely notched out if you wanted it to look more professional. But other than bending that, there was no modifications needed to be made to the truck, really. Other than bending that, drilling four small holes and cutting out one 4 5/8 inch hole. And that's pretty much it. Pretty cool, because although the description says less than 2 hours with no help needed, I'm guessing that's if you're like a veteran at installing gooseneck hitches, even this style, which is a pretty simple setup. Conservatively, I want to say probably took 3 hours of actually working on it. Maybe four, probably. But then of course, some of the parts are missing, which some of the reviews said that, like when you get your thing, just so you know, you're gonna have to go to the hardware store because their packaging is too sensitive for how heavy that stuff is. And it's not wrapped in any kind of styrofoam or anything to protect the boxes from getting destroyed. So they just got ripped apart. Stuff was missing. Luckily, I had some of the stuff that I needed to match it up at the hardware store so I could get the same grade 8 stuff that I needed, and we're all good to go. I mean, it's pretty legit. Everything that I could get my impact on, I hit it with my Milwaukee impact gun, and then there was just a lot of stuff that was like hand torque, and then it gave you a certain spec and stuff, so we just did all that stuff by hand. And for the most part though, the thing is, I mean, everything that we finished up felt freaking solid. I don't have any doubts that it's gonna be totally good. Probably wouldn't hurt to go back through and just make sure everything's tight after a couple of trips with the trailer, just to make sure nothing like vibrated loose or anything. But I mean, the hardware that's on there, everything felt pretty freaking tight when we were done. I'm pretty happy with it. I don't know if you can just reach under and see anything. Like you can see the hardware underneath there. You can see the pin system. You can tilt it to the left there, get it out of the way to swap your ball, release it, locks in. It's pretty sweet, pretty stout. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the install of that gooseneck hitch, and hopefully we can bring you guys a first pull review here very soon. For those of you that have any interest in super cool pre-emissions diesel trucks that are involved in a giveaway that is ending in literally like hardly more than 2 weeks, this is your shot. Rosine, the 24 valve, we're talking 7 inches of lift, 35s, 20 by 12 anthems. Guys, it's ready to go. The thing that we need is for you to get your order in so that way you can take this thing home. There's kind of a process. It's like where you like enter and then like you could win a truck. It's pretty sick, but you got to get entered. You never find out if this truck could have been yours. Let's take the chance. Thanks so much, guys. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.